As you've seen on the show in recent weeks, hospitals and healthcare systems have joined the call for better public health behavior by New Mexicans. We heard from doctors at Loveless, Presbyterian, and UNM again this week and asked them what people can do if family won't stay away during the holidays. Again, while they have given their thoughts about how to cope with another stay-at-home order, there's no COVID-safe option for gathering. The official word is, don't do it.
I think our advice would be, first and foremost, not to gather with anyone who's outside your pod. And think about creative ways, like a Zoom dinner or dropping off food at people's doorsteps. And that would be our first suggestion to families. If you are going to gather, and if you do have the luxury of time and are able to quarantine, if you're coming in from elsewhere, that would be helpful. There's also a few things you can do, like make sure that one pod is doing the cooking and multiple families who have not been in contact with each other are not all involved with food preparation. As you've seen, the CDC guidelines suggest that if you have not had contact with people and you're coming into contact with them over Thanksgiving, to wear a mask, even indoors, except when you're eating and drinking, to keep that mask on as much as possible. So if you have the ability to have heaters and have your meal outside, a fire pit or outdoor heaters, that would be a safer way to celebrate Thanksgiving as well. But, you know, all said and done, I would urge our community to think about who they want at the Thanksgiving dinner table next year as they take these decisions.
We are seeing our hospitals filled well beyond what is our typical capacity. We know that these policy changes will have a positive impact on hospitalizations, will help in our ICUs, and will lead patients, people, citizens, to do all the right things and not to engage in those risky behaviors that do spread COVID-19. We do have to find ways to get past this surge. As Dr. McKee noted, we're all very tired, not just healthcare workers, but as citizens in this state of having to go under restrictions. But it is very important. We can be creative, though, in finding ways to get past this. So as somebody who enjoys food and cooking, I've done quite a bit of that lately, but I would encourage people to do as I've done and figure out ways to support local businesses while still doing the things that we enjoy. So I've signed up for a couple of subscriptions at local restaurants and continue to support them as a local business, as well as do something that I enjoy.